National slammed Te Pāti Māori's claims about an alleged trespass on candidate Hana-Rāwhiti Maipi-Clarke's home, labelling it a political stunt. They say the National Party supporter went to her home to congratulate her and was invited inside. Te Pāti Māori President John Tamihere joins us now. Morena, is this a political stunt?
When some of these homes invaded, not once but twice burgled first, and secondly, an uninvited person comes onto the property and into the house, if you're going to congratulate somebody for a debate, you do that after the debate. I've done. I've been around a long time. You don't wait till 5 days after the first burglary to turn up at a house. This young candidate has been got at for political reasons. Now, the fact that the guy's a National Party supporter with hoardings and that, and turns up, is there a connection between that and the first burglary? We're working our way through that. But it's really up for the Human Rights Commission to determine racial profiling and the like. We all know police racially profile. We know there's ethnic profiling. Just this week, a judge had to throw out charges against two young Māori males. Now, so I'm just trying to say to you that we want a fair shake, because I promised this girl and her mother and her grandfather that she would be protected if she stood. And young people deserve to be part of the political process, and they don't deserve to be treated like this.
Now, Graham is the 74-year-old man that turned up at Hana's home. Police have issued him with a trespass notice after he was asked to leave by an occupant of the home. Correct. His version was that he went to the house to wish her all the best. He was impressed by her when he heard her speak at a candidate's meeting, and that there was no malicious intent. What is your version of the events then?
Well,
happened
well,
when
hang
you
on,
turned
hang
up?
Hang on, Huntley's a very small place. He lives just up the road. So Hunter's partner followed him after asking him to leave the property uninvited, and then followed him up the road to where his house is. That's how we identify him.
Did he knock on the door? Like,
No, he didn't knock on the door. What happened was that their car was away, for all intents and purposes, the house might have been unoccupied. He walked up to the door and Hana's partner opened the door, right? He pushed his way through, saying, "Where's Hana? I want to talk to her." Now, if you get sprung like that, that's a possibility. But, hey, no one should have that entitled, inappropriate conduct. And if he was going to come onto somebody's house, his wife was just down the road with him. You bring your wife along. It just doesn't stack up for us.
So when you say he pushed his way past Hana's husband, so he knocked, he came to the door, her husband opened the door, and then he walked past him. Is that
The police have chosen to believe his statement of facts as opposed to her partner's. I'll just leave it at that. There are ways to unbundle this, but let's get it right. No candidate advancing in a free democracy, their political rights and entitlements should ever be subjected to this. This is one of the first times in our political history that we've seen this.
Mm. Graham said that you should get your facts right before you spout your mouth off.
Oh, yeah, well, we'll see him in court not too far away from here, because if the police aren't willing to apply the law, we'll have to go to civil proceedings. Now, the problem we've got with that is that now our people are going to have to defend themselves. See, now you're saying the police are starting to say, well, vigilantism is good. It is not. It is up to the police to be fair on this and to sort it out.
There were a couple of other incidents that have been reported.
Five all up.
Yep. Five all up. Mm. So in terms of those other incidences, the police are saying, although they're still looking into things, they don't believe that these incidents have been racially motivated or coordinated.
Yeah, well, it's a bit early in any investigation to make those statements, isn't it? They haven't uncovered whether the first three incidents are related to this bloke, right? Because they say they're still investigating them. But here's the thing. They've issued a trespass notice on him. Clearly he's in breach of the Trespass Act, so clearly he's breached the law. Now, what I'm going to tell you is a fact. If he was a Māori, he would have been charged for being unlawfully on private property. No charges rendered. See, the bounce of the ball is the problem here in terms of the way in which police discretions are used. That's all I'm saying as well. That's a matter of fact.
Now, there was also a threatening letter that was reported to have been left at the house on one of those other occasions that you're speaking about. What was actually contained in that letter that made it a threat?
Well, see, it's a head job that they're trying to work out on this kid, because what they did was took a photo of a prescription that they got out of the rubbish bin in her house out of the burglary. there were five brand new boxes of Jordans in the house. So the red bands, the onesies, and the Jordans weren't touched. You know what that tells you and me? Weren't Māori's. So we know exactly what the problem was and what they were trying to do. So why would somebody go to that extent? Then they wrote on the note, you support dumping and kapai to you, Māori girl, right? Now, it's in handwriting.
So where's the threat?
Here's the handwriting. Well, why would you do that? What was the reason behind taking the photo of her prescription to say, I've been in your house, you know, I've violated your presence, and this is what I'm saying? Don't you find that threatening? Would you find that threatening if that note was left?
Well, I'd be disturbed that somebody was inside my house, I guess.
Well, please. I mean, why is the trial? Why is she on trial? Why am I on trial? Why don't the police go and find the perpetrators?
So what now then? If the police are saying that they've done their investigations, and yes, there are still things that they're looking into, what now then? What does Te Pāti Māori do at this stage?
Well, we've exhausted our channels because the only people that look after the criminal justice system are the cops. Now, if I was in Huntley or Hamilton, I'd be deeply disturbed. If I was in West Auckland, because I understand the policing there, I'd have a totally different view of things. So our problem is then we are obliged to take civil action against Mr. Gunn over his entry and unlawful entry into her property. Then we can unwind exactly what happened with the investigation.
Is it fair, and I know that these have been comments from you in the past, around pinning this towards National and ACT, what is happening to Hana?
Well, there's a political unpacking, which is not criminal. Right. And the political unpacking is clearly there has been race baiting, from attacking our language over English language signs, attacking us over co-governance, attacking us in regards to beneficiaries, crime and the like. So that's cool. That's in the political discourse. When it licenses people to tip into going into people's places, particularly our young and vulnerable candidates, where we're trying to get our young people involved in the political narrative, that is unacceptable conduct in any democracy.
In all of this, you said earlier that you had been asked by the whānau whether you could actually keep Hana safe, and here we are talking around things that have happened at her home. What we must remember is this is a 21-year-old a young woman that is at the centre of this, and I wonder how she's doing. How is she coping with the amount of, spotlight that's been put on her, but not only that, the fact that somebody has entered her home?
Well, we're going to speak our truth, and she's deeply traumatised by it, and it's been very difficult for her on the campaign trail, and that's what it was meant to do. That's what this is meant to do. It was to play with her head and put her down. And it's unacceptable. And we should not allow that conduct to continue against any candidate, let alone a young Māori girl who has extraordinary promise and extraordinary energy and will do very well in that seat.
Tēnā te mihi atu ki a koe. Appreciate your time this morning. John Tamihere, Te Pāti Māori President, joining us this morning. Right.